Okay, guys, so as you can see, we got so many options to go through from this VMware host client graphical interface. So we are going to be looking around and see everything is going to be in this tutorial. That's why, you know, it's going to be like 7-8 tutorials just to show you this VMware host client graphical interface that you can use to manage one host. Remember, only one host. Okay, so let's go and keep on going. All right,
you have the option for the CD and DVD. You can select an ISO file if you have one. Usually you are gonna use this option for the ISO file to select an ISO for a Windows, an operating system, or an OVF, or, you know, open VMware format and stuff like that. Let me cancel this out. You also have the option for video card, so how much memory you wanna put into this video card, the total video memory, and stuff like that. All right. So if we go to, let me cancel this out. Right. Let me go back. Open edit settings once again. I also wanted to show you, you know, the VM options right in here. Here you're gonna have, you know, a lot of more options for this virtual machine. In general, you have these options right there for guest OS version and stuff like that. You can see, you know, what is going on in here, right? You have the VMware remote cancel options too. Can make changes right in there. VMware tools, as you already know, after you create a VM, you install the operating system, and then you need to run the installation for the VMware tools. So that VM is gonna have better performance, better, you know, video quality. If the NIC card that you have in the physical server do not have the driver, maybe, you know, the VMware tool is gonna help you and provide, you know, some generic, you know, drivers for that NIC card, right? Just to give you an example, okay? You have the power management right here. Wake up online, standby, response, stuff like that. Boot options. All right, so you got the boot options to get into the BIOS, to do a delay and stuff like this. You can force or you can delay the BIOS to show, for example, every time that you power on a computer in a VM environment, the options to get into the BIOS is gonna disappear right away. Like, boom, it's gonna be too fast. So you can delay that process from here and then input any key to get into the BIOS settings, all right? We have the advanced right in there. You can add a configuration, input any value right in here. You got all this. You can add parameters and more, okay? So let's go to Fiverr. This is just, you know, if you have Fiverr in your environment, you can, you know, use this option. Alright, let me cancel this out. And let's see what actions we have in here. So pretty much the same ones that I went through already. Let's go to the next option in this navigator, which is gonna be a storage. Alright, so as you can see, I only have one local data store, which is this one. In this data store, I have all the files for this virtual machine that I created right in there. So we have the nvrun, the vndk, the vmsd, the vmx, the vmx lag, and more, right? So I already went through all this information in the VN tutorials. If you wanna take a look at it, so it's available on my channel. So let's go to ISO. As you can see, I have one ISO for Windows 7. And I use this ISO to run the installation for the virtual machine, right? To install Windows 7. You wanna upload, you can upload it from your local computer. You wanna download, you can download it to your computer and stuff like that. You can delete, you can move, you can copy, you can create a directory. So it's gonna create a folder like this. You can refresh and close.